Yeah, for the people who have the problem with the CX9, the opener, we're gonna fix it today. First, we're gonna have to remove the screw here. We use a 15 millimeter to remove this. Yep, after we remove it, we have two pieces. One this one and this. And then we have to open up this panel. Then we use the 10 millimeter socket and a Phillips screwdriver. Phillips screwdriver open here. And a 10 millimeter here, and here. So after we open all this, we're gonna peel this panel so we can see the opener. Look, that's the opener. The opener is right there. We remove that screw and we see the opener there. Look. So you simply just pull it out. Yep. And, I clean up my good already. So I'm gonna show you how to open this. And the reason why is here, the tip, this tip's inside is corroded, so it jam all the time. So that's the reason why the opener is not open correctly, and sometimes you can't even close the leak cover. So we have to disassemble this and we clean it up. So this piece, if you order from a Master Parts, it's $30-something plus tax, it will be 40. But instead you can clean it up and fix the problem, so you don't have to waste the money. And it's very easy to disassemble. And you need this metal brush to clean it up. So this is how we disassemble it. There's a spring here. Remove this spring. First, we remove this cable first. And then we remove this spring. This spring. And then we have to remove this cable from it. Then we have to push this all the way, and the little ball can come out. And we have to remove this black piece out. Look, I already cleaned it. So it's very smooth now. Before it was stuck because inside is heavily corroded, so it stuck a lot of the metal or dirt inside there, so it's not moving smoothly. Now it's moving smoothly. So when we remove this, there's a trick. This one got to pop out a little bit. Now it pop. So over here you have to do the push from here. come out all the way. This, when you put it back in, you go like this first, then you twist to here, then you twist. Very have to be gentle, otherwise you're gonna break this rubber in the half, so you don't want to do that. And after that, we have to use a brush in there and you clean it good, because you make sure inside there's no more dirt. I used while using the brush, I use alcohol and it clean up after I brush. So I'm gonna apply this film, silicone film, to lubricate it. Put a bit of it in there. So now we put it back. Yep, we light it up like that. This when you push in, so now it's lubricated. Then we're gonna put this the wire back. Put the spring, this spring back, hook here, and then connect it to the black pieces. Then we're gonna put it back. This hook face under. This little dial face up. Then we put it back to the where it belongs to. Stop. Okay. Then we put this one like that. Put this back. Then we're gonna use a 15mm check. Tie it up, and the problem will disappear. Not like before. Before you can't, I can't even close it. Every time I close it, when I'm driving, it pop open again because that little lock jam inside, not popping up. So now the problem solved. We don't have to buy the parts from the master. Instead of that, just clean it up and put it back so it works like new. Thanks for watching.